Hey everyone, Daniel, Rachel, and Carlton here from Mango Street. And today we're gonna show you how you can add motion graphics to your video. I'll even provide the footage that we use in the link below so you can follow along. And if you don't own After Effects, you can get it for $20 a month through Adobe Creative Cloud, or you can get a free trial from Adobe as well. So the first thing that you'll wanna do is get the pen tool. That's G on your keyboard, or you can click it right here in the toolbar. The first thing that we'll do is just trace the lines that are on the tarmac with the pen tool. And you wanna make sure that you do not have your footage selected below. You want to make sure that nothing is selected so it makes a new shape layer right above it. So after you draw the 4 points for that line, you can hit the V key or hit the arrow over here to switch your tool. And you can adjust your points to match up just the way you want it. Also make sure that your fill is set off. You can click the word fill right there, select that icon right there to make sure there's no fill, and then have a stroke. I have it set to white and it's a thickness of 9 pixels. You can also adjust that as you'd like. With that first line drawn, we'll do the same thing on the right side and we can actually draw another path inside the same shape layer. So we'll just select that shape layer one, select our pen tool and start drawing. All right, and then you can hit the V key to switch your tool to the move tool, and then you can adjust your path as necessary. So now you may notice that there are some elements that cross in front of the lines on the tarmac, and we wanna mask those out above our painted on lines. And so to do that, we'll duplicate the footage and then just draw a mask around each element. Select the airplane time-lapse, hit Command D, and then you can hit Command right bracket. And if you're on a PC, replace Command for Control. And so now let's start by masking out this vehicle right here. So select your pen tool. If you click and drag, that'll create Bezier handles and that'll help you make curved lines as opposed to straight lines. So we'll just do a pretty quick and dirty job. You can spend more time on this as you'd like, but for this example, this will suffice. We really just need to mask out the section of the vehicle that crosses over the painted area. So this should be enough. We'll just go ahead and close the path by clicking back to where we started from. Now you can also make adjustments to this path by feathering it a little bit, and that makes it the mask a little softer. So with the airplane time-lapse selected, hit F on your keyboard, and then you can adjust the pixels. And then you don't want to go overboard with this because it looks pretty silly really fast. So I usually just do around 1 should work fine just to soften it a little bit. With that complete, we can do the same thing over here with this vehicle. It may help to turn off our path so we can see exactly what we are gonna mask out. Like I said, this is a quick and dirty way. You can definitely spend more time to make it a little neater path. Add a feather of 1 again. All right, so now that we have 2 of those basic items done, let's hit up this last one, which is the wheel and staircase here. So once again, click your airplane time-lapse layer and let's draw around the wheel. Once again, I'll feather that as well. Hit F on your keyboard. And let's turn our path. And that looks all right. It's a little sloppy. So now let's go ahead and animate the lines. In order to do that, we're gonna add something called trim paths. So back on our shape layer, if we double tap U on the keyboard, it'll open up these properties that we have. The shape 2 is our right path. We can click on that, hit enter, and type in right path. Shape 1, let's label that left path. All right, so with left path selected, I'm gonna click the arrow next to add right here. I'm gonna go down to where it says trim paths. If we open those options, you can see we have a start and end. And you can just play with that value to see exactly what it does. And so that's exactly what we want. And so let's click the stopwatch next to end. And right now we have the finished animation of the path already animating on. I wanna move this keyframe over in time about 10 frames. So I hit shift option right arrow and that moves that keyframe later in time by 10 frames. And now I'm gonna change the value of the end to be 0. And if we hit spacebar, you can see we have it animating on just like that. That was a little quick. I'm actually gonna move it to be 12 frames. If you highlight that, you can click and drag it or you can hit option or alt and right arrow. Now we have a 12 frame animation, but then I also want the line to animate off. And so to do that, we animate the start value. I'm gonna go back around 3 frames from the end, click the stopwatch next to start, and now I'm gonna move forward in time about 10 frames. To move over in time, you can hit Command and your right and left arrows, and that moves 1 frame at a time. Now I'll change the start value to be 100, and as you can see, the line has disappeared, so let's go ahead and play back and see what it looks like. Perfect. Now we can do the same thing over here on the right side. You can copy the entire trim pass animator by selecting it, then hitting Command or Control C on your keyboard, clicking on the right path and hitting Command V and pasting it. Now you can see we have the same effect on both sides. So the other thing to notice is over here, our path is a little off. So let's clean that up a little bit. And you can make any adjustments as needed, depending on the length of your animation. If you want to mask out these people that walk in front of it, you can do that as well. All you have to do is select the mask layer, which I will rename mask, and start drawing with the pen tool to make another mask. Since they're only on for just 1 or 2 frames, then they're gone, yeah. You want to keyframe your mask. In order to do that, double tap M on your keyboard, and next to mask 4, which is this mask here, we'll click the stopwatch next to mask path. Let's move back 1 frame where they cross in front again. Hit the V key on your keyboard to switch to the arrow tool over here, and then we'll just drag our mask to match up with where he is now. And you can make any adjustments as needed. You can even add another point to the mask to better refine it. And we can do the same thing with this guy here. And since they are no longer crossing our path, we can get rid of that mask altogether. And so the way I do that is I'll take the mask, double click it with the arrow tool, and I just move it completely out of frame. And that way we don't have to worry about it anymore. And that position is keyframed right here. And I'll do the same thing before they come into frame. All right, so there we have all the basics of this animation. The one final thing I did do is I added a glow to the line. And so you can do that by selecting our shape layer, going over to the effects panel, and type in glow. Double click the glow effect. And then you can play around with the radius and intensity values to get just where you want it. So we'll move to a point in time where we see the path on screen. And let's up the intensity to around 6. And let's up the radius. And there we have it. And now you can export for Premiere. In order to do that, we'll hit Command Control M or select Composition, Add to Render Queue. We'll change it to be H.264 and select your destination to be exactly where you want it to export. And then hit Render. I'll also include this clip here available to download if you want to do the shoe hitting the pavement effect as well. Same concept applies as it does with the airplane one. And just let us know if you have any questions in the comments.
Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, leave them for Daniel in the comment section of this video. And like and subscribe if you haven't already. We want to collaborate with more YouTubers in this genre, so leave a comment on your favorite YouTuber's channel and tell them to collaborate with us. Bye.